We're learning about what will be the priorities of Team Trump. We're getting some ideas right now from Steve Koch. He is on the list from a Trump insider looking at what they're looking at. Steve, what can you tell us? I know you don't want to give away everything here, first of all, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
And now, you know, high expectations for you and, sure. and for the team. You want to take advantage, obviously, of the Republican House, Republican right. Senate, run of the table, the reverse of what Barack Obama had coming in. What do you plan to do?
Well, the first thing I want to address is, you know, this populist comment around running the table, and that sounds very exciting and whatnot. But what I've really experienced so far from the entire team is not any gloating at all. The first priority has been about how can we bring people together to address these things that simply haven't worked, the rut that the economy's been in. We talked about tax, trade, deregulation, you know, and even energy, and how can we be most impactful in a cooperative way to build bonds across the aisle to get these things through in a proper and legal manner.
Yeah, that's great. So how are you going to run the table with that? I'm kidding. But, you know, there are some things that are easier to get through or at least push through, you know, in an environment like this than others.
Sure.
And then others require, especially if you're going to make substantial changes to the tax code, that's something that in the Senate would require 60 votes. But could you just steer me through what would be, in your mind, priorities?
Sure. I think the priorities have been very clearly laid out by President-elect Trump. First of all, with the repeal and replacement of Obamacare, you know, if you look at the priorities there, getting rid of the subsidies, for example, the individual mandate for folks that didn't want insurance or didn't feel that they needed that type of insurance, and then most importantly, the employer mandate. So instead of having great insurance packages and as a benefit and an incentive to both attract, retain, and maintain great employees, having that jammed down your throat as a not such a good plan, mandated, that most folks didn't like, and frankly, employers were grossly overpaying for. And then when it comes to Dodd-Frank, obviously, you know, we're looking at regulatory exemptions, specifically for community banks and regional banks. Let's get the money back on Main Street so that we can get money out to small businesses and entrepreneurs and people in communities around America that understand the story. And when it comes back, when it comes to deregulation, get some community bank relief so we can get that money back on the streets. And then, of course, you know, everything around mortgage and consumer finance, the reintroduction of new safe lending products to get money out to Americans to help them live the American dream. I've been working on powering the American dream for more than 22 years, and I can tell you, next to wearing the uniform of this country, there's no greater honor that I've ever experienced in my life.
Well, what about those tax cuts then? How would those be emphasized, and how would they be rolled out?
Well, look, as you said, we are going to need the support of a greater number of members of Congress. I think the markets have reacted. I think the people have spoken. I think that the public markets show better than anyone. If you'll remember back in April, my rather strong arguments that the markets would react very favorably to a 20% cut in the corporate tax rate and to simplification of personal taxes.
So that's still on the table, right, Steve? I mean, would that be among
100%.
The initial things done right from the get-go? In other words, try to
absolutely.
Push through those lower taxes.
Look, you have to understand that Mr. Trump fully intends to execute on all the promises that he's made, and he's surrounding himself with people that are going to work on those agendas, make the deals necessary to get those through Congress and to the American people as promised as quickly as possible. People are begging for it, and the markets have reacted. They love it. Let's move forward to fan the flame of entrepreneurial spirit and to get us back on track again.
All right, Steve, thank you very much for taking the time out of Chicago.
My pleasure.